Hello, hello, and welcome to this 6-day training. So my name is Laura Dixon, and I am a life and weight loss coach, and I help women become naturally thin and thin for life. And when I say thin, I mean being in the body that you know feels right and that you're meant to be in. It isn't as much about the number on the scale as it is feeling like you are just feeling right in your body, feeling like you go throughout your day, you eat when you're hungry, you stop when you're satisfied, you're out of the deprivation, restriction, binging cycle. Being thin becomes just part of who you are, and it's no longer something you're actively trying to force and actively trying to do. And so I really think about it as being a state of being. Like, you know those women that you see, whether they're your friends or you watch them from a distance. I used to watch a lot of them from the distance, that it just, like, food wasn't a thing for them. Like, sure, they enjoyed eating. They genuinely liked to eat, but they didn't have it become such a central focal point of their life. And so that, to me, is really being naturally thin, is being at your goal weight, being at your ideal weight, having it be effortless, and not just getting there, but being able to stay there in a way that doesn't feel so hard. So I'm going to walk you through these 6 days. I'm going to give you the most powerful tools that I have, that I use with all of my one-on-one clients, to help you really change how you think about losing weight and really change how you think about your relationship with food and your relationship with yourself. And so today I'm going to walk you through the model, which is one of the most powerful tools I use, and we use it all throughout these 6 days. But before I do, I want you to think about this. I want you to think about and commit to going through these 6 days. If you're anything like me, I tried diet after diet after diet after diet. Some lasted a day or two, some lasted a few months, some even lasted longer than that, but I always ended up giving up. And I always ended up stopping. And I always made it mean something about me as a person. And I want you to commit to yourself to doing these 6 days, to really going all the way through and then deciding if this is something that you want to continue to implement in your life. And I know through personal experience and my clients' experience, this will completely change your life. And it will completely change how you think about food and how you think about yourself. So here we go. We're going to dive right in. 6 days. Today is day one, and I'm going to walk you through the model. So as we're doing this, in everything I do throughout these 6 days, it's really to help you and to show you how to change how you think about food and to change how you think about yourself, so that losing weight, being naturally thin, it becomes something that becomes just something that is a part of you. It's no longer something you're actively trying to chase after. So the model is a tool developed by Brooke Castillo. She owns the Life Coach School, and I am a certified coach, and I use a lot of tools from that original certification process. But what I found was, for my own journey and for my clients' journeys, the Life Coach School tools were so much more powerful, and they really amplified all of the other tools in the other training I had. So then I decided that it made sense for me to go through her certification process. So the tool that she uses, her kind of primary tool, is called the model, and it's a way of describing how the world works. And so even when we think about it, if you've done a lot of self-help, it might be very similar to other things you've seen or other things you've heard or other things you've tried. And how she talks about it is, there's gravity, and then there's a bunch of different ways to describe it and measure it. But whoever finds or invents a tool to describe gravity or to measure gravity, they didn't invent gravity. So this is like her tool, but what we're describing, it just is, and it just exists. And so this, though, is a very analytical way that I like to look at it. We can see it on paper. It separates and detaches ourselves from ourselves in a very powerful way. So the model is this. It is CTFAR, and so you may have seen that before. I know many people that I introduced this to have heard this before in maybe a slightly different form, or maybe in this particular form, and there's usually one of two camps. Either you're like, of course, this is of course how the world works, or you're like me. I was like, not so sure about this. But stick with me for a minute, and then we're going to talk about how this applies to you losing weight. So there are circumstances in the world which are always neutral. They are the facts. They are things you could prove in a court of law. It's what someone says, the words that come out of their mouth, the words in a text message. And then we have sentences in our mind. Like your, for example, if I go back to this, sorry, your weight would go there, how many pounds you weigh. And then you have a thought about it, a sentence that runs through your mind. And those sentences are optional thoughts that don't always feel optional. But when we have a thought, our neurons in our brain fire together. And as they fire together over and over and over again, if you've ever heard the phrase neurons that fire together, wire together. So as they do that repeatedly, they start to create neural networks in our brain. And the longer they do that, the deeper the groove, the stronger the connection is, and then it starts to become a belief, like a deep-rooted belief that we have. And these sentences in our mind then produce an emotion in our body. And so how it works on a biological level is we have, when those neurons fire together, they then send a signal to our hypothalamus that releases peptides into our body that produce the physical sensation, the vibration that we experience, an emotion. And those emotions, that feeling drives all of our action and all of our inaction. So our action is what we do, and very importantly, what we don't do. And all of the things we do and all of the things we don't do, add all of those up together, and it creates all of the results that we have in our life. And so this is so important because we're going to understand how your thoughts and your feelings and your action are creating the result that you currently have when it comes to weight and food, and how to use that to fuel you forward and empower you to create a different weight and a different relationship with food and a different relationship with yourself that serves you for the rest of your life. And so the goal of this, and I'm going to walk you through some examples, but the goal of this is awareness and responsibility, really understanding what is happening so that we can change it. But it comes first from that awareness of what is currently happening for us. And the way I really like to use it, and the way that I use the model in my own life that I found so powerful, was that it all comes back to me. Let me move this a little bit so you can see the responsibility. So that it all comes back to me, and that I am responsible for all of my results and that I can change them. And using it in a way of serving me to getting me to where I want to be in my life. So let's walk through a few examples. So let's say weight. You're going to think about your weight. And so I'm going to walk you through kind of some common things, some common thoughts, some common models. And some of these were my own models before I really got to the place where I now am naturally thin and think totally different about all of this. So if you have your weight and put whatever your weight is there, pounds, stones, kilograms, whatever, you just put your weight in the circumstance line. So that's neutral. We could take a picture, we could take it to a court of law. If there were 100 people standing around us with the scale, we would all agree the number. It's very factual. And then we have a thought about it. And a lot of times a thought might be, let's say it's, I don't know what to do. So let's say your weight's 180 pounds. You put whatever it is, 180, 300, 150. I don't know what to do. And how do you feel then when you have the thought, I don't know what to do? And it's really important that you ask yourself, what emotion does that create for me? And for example, let's say that's confused. And then you ask yourself, what do I do when I'm confused? For me, I spin in my mind. I kind of have these thought loops. I distract myself. I overeat. I don't plan what I'm going to eat. I don't exercise. I definitely don't make a decision about doing something. And so the result I create is that I don't do anything and I stay stuck at 180 pounds. And the really important thing to see is that our thought always ends up in our results. The way that we're thinking always ends up in the result we're creating because it drives the emotion that fuels our action that creates our result for us. So seeing that it isn't the fact that I weigh 180 pounds, it isn't the weight that's causing you to not do anything, which is what we think it is, right? Like I used to get on the scale and think like, that's why I'm feeling so terrible right now. But what we're missing is that we're having a thought here about it. And this is where all of our power lies, because when we can understand what we're thinking and what we're believing, then we can understand how to change it to get to where we want to be. Because especially with dieting, when you think about what a diet is this. It's our action. It's what are you going to do? What are you not going to do? You're going to eat this and you're not going to eat this. You're going to count this and not eat this. And you're going to exercise and you're not going to like write all of the things. It's so focused on the action, which we can force and we can willpower and we can white knuckle for a while. But when we haven't aligned our thoughts and our feelings, this is always going to feel forced. It's always going to feel like it's so hard. And so the way we get to be naturally thin and naturally thin for life is we align how we want to be showing up with what we're thinking and feeling. Because then it doesn't feel like we have to force anything. It just becomes part of who we are. So this, for me, I'm going to go through two of my main models that I really struggled with then when I was trying to lose the weight and lose it for the last time. And so my weight, I don't know why I started at 180, now we're at 190, but my weight, it's about 190 pounds. And I had the thought, I'm never going to get out of this. So it was like, step on the scale, see 190, and I had the thought, I'm never going to get out of this, and I would feel trapped. And I would think it's the number on the scale that's causing me to feel trapped, but it was the thought, I'm never going to get out of this. And when I felt trapped, I would then, my action would be to overeat, to watch TV, to distract myself with social media, to drink wine, to not exercise. And the result I created was that I never got out of this, out of that, and I made no change, and I stayed at 190 pounds. And I thought it was the weight that was causing me to feel trapped that was then why I was doing all of these things. But what we miss here is that I had this thought, this belief that felt so real and so true to me of I'm never going to get out of this. And so if that is also you, I want you to ask yourself, what do you think about your weight? What do you think about your ability to get to a place where this is no longer a struggle for you? That is so important, and we are going to talk about that throughout all of these 6 days and how to start to shift that. But we can't know what to shift until we know what it is we need to shift from. Like, we need to know our baseline, our starting point. So it's so important to see what it is that you're thinking. So then this is kind of what I cycled through and created. And then what happens is when I don't change and I continue to see 190 pounds or it starts to go up, it's like then it just like the thought is like, I'm never going to get out of this. And my brain just started to associate that number on the scale with I'm never going to get out of this and feeling trapped. And it starts to perpetuate this cycle. But then what happened for me is something completely different. So I had the same weight. I still weighed 190 pounds, but I read this book, and I've shared this before if you've listened to any of my other work, that I read the book called Naturally Thin by Bethany Frankel, and she talked about her struggle and how she struggled with food and how she changed how she thought about food. And there's nothing kind of completely, there's no like magical pill in that book. But what happened for me is I then had a complete shift in what I saw that was possible for me. I saw someone else go through a journey where they struggled with food, struggled with their body image, struggled with all of that, and came out on the other side where it seemed effortless. And so I started then practicing the belief over and over and over again, I will be naturally thin. Like BF is Bethany Frankel, I will be naturally thin like Bethany Frankel. And I became so determined. I wrote determined here, and I was like, actually it was more like an obsessive determination, maybe fanatical, that then from that emotion that fueled me to read books on being thin, I studied how to change, I practiced new thinking, I thought of my future self, I stopped overeating, I released the pressure of losing weight off of exercise, I listened to podcasts, I did so many things that was so fueled because of this different thought. So I want you to see the circumstance didn't change. I still weighed 190 pounds. But this thought over and over and over and over and over again that I practiced ended up creating a result for me of 140 pounds that I became naturally thin and I lost 50 pounds. Sorry, let me move this up a little bit so you can see that. So I want you to see how powerful our thoughts are, that it is that powerful that we can not change our circumstance. We don't have to change our husband. We don't have to change the food that's in our house. We don't have to change even our weight to get started. We don't have to wait until we get there. We start practicing it all along the way. And so I want you to ask yourself, what do you currently think about your weight? What is keeping you in that same perpetuation? What is keeping you in that same cycle? And how can you start to see that it's possible that you could achieve something different? So here's how I want you to get started. I want you to dump out on paper all of your thoughts about your weight, all of your thoughts about food, all of your thoughts about yourself losing weight. And then I want you to pick one thought and run your own model. I want you to see how your thinking has created that result. I want you to see how that thought, pick anyone. It's kind of, there's a coach that I've heard say, all roads lead to Rome. Like, pick one thought and put that in your model. So you're going to have your weight in your circumstance line, 180 pounds, 250 pounds, 140 pounds, whatever it is. You're going to put that in your circumstance line and then tell me and put your predominant thought in there and then really ask yourself, what emotion is that for you? What feeling is that for you? You pick one word emotion and then ask yourself, when I'm feeling that way, what do I do? What do I not do? All of the action that I take from that one emotion, how and what result does that create for me? And you will see that thought ends up creating that result and how tied they are together because of how that feels and the action you take and the inaction. And really seeing for you, like, what are some of your predominant thoughts so we know what we're going to start to work on. And then the third step is I want you to run an intentional model with a thought you want to practice. So what I gave you, my two examples, was I'm never going to get out of this. That was step number two, my kind of most predominant thought about my weight. And then my intentional model was I will be naturally thin. And you want to ask yourself, it's really important to not just practice the thought like a mantra, but to really see what thought could I start to believe. What thought could I start to see being real for myself before I have any evidence for it? And then the way you do that, like, how do I, different from a mantra, is how does it feel in my body? Like, how can I really, like, do I feel that in my body? And that's a cue that we know there's a part of us that does believe it. Because when we practice the thoughts in a sort of typical mantra way that we don't believe, that no part of us believes it, our brain, that neural connection doesn't happen. And so it doesn't start to create this new neural network that we can then practice and rely on because it's so far, it's so distant from where we currently are. So I want you to really ask yourself, what are all of the thoughts I think about myself? How does that play out? We'll do one model and then do another model with an intentional thought. And so I've given you a worksheet to do this with, and I will give you a worksheet most every day with each one of these videos. I think except with the hormone video, every single one has a worksheet that you can do. And so print out the worksheet and really do the worksheet and do it on paper, because where the problem is up here. It's in our mind, and it's so ingrained in us that when we do it on paper, we get to separate ourselves from it. We get to put distance. We get to observe it in a different way, and we use a different part of our brain when we're doing that so that we can start to make progress forward, so that we can start to unlearn how we currently think about food and relearn in a new way that does serve us. So the last thing I want you to think about and that I want to share with you is, here are some common thoughts that we believe are facts. And with this, I don't even think about any emotion as being good or bad, or any thought being good or bad, or any food being good or bad. I like to think about it is in a way of, does it serve me? Does it serve me? And there are, for example, emotions, like, there are some emotions that serve me. Like, of course, I want to feel grief. Of course, I want to feel devastation at times based on how I'm thinking about a certain circumstance. But sometimes that negative emotion, it does serve me. And so asking yourself and getting out of the, well, this is bad and this is good, of just, does it serve me? Does it serve me getting to where I want to be? Does it serve me in my life? So some of the most common thoughts that I used to tell myself and that I hear my clients tell me are, well, I just deserve it. Food just tastes too good for me. I like food more than her. Food is relaxing. I need chocolate to decompress, or wine, or whatever it is for you. Food helps me when I'm stressed. Like, think about all of these thoughts, all of these things that you think about food that feel so real because your brain is so used to practicing that neural connection. Your brain is so used to telling itself over and over and over again. And so even all of these, I want you to question what you think about food and how you think about food. And I want to show you in a model how some of these may not actually serve you. So for example, let's say it's 8 p.m. is your circumstance, and you have the thought, I deserve food, I had a hard day. What emotion does that produce for you? It usually promotes desire to eat. And so then our action is going to be to overeat. Maybe we also watch TV, we don't go for a walk, we don't talk to our husband, but that feeling of desire, I deserve food, I had a hard day, right? Even if you talk to your friends, they'd probably agree with you. And so even in society, we see that, like, of course, right? But asking yourself, believing that thought that using food to decompress, that I deserve food when I'm feeling stressed or when I'm feeling anxious, does that serve you? Because all of this action and inaction leads to an increased desire for food. You're training your mind to believe you deserve food. You're training your mind and your body to believe it is not able to process another emotion. And we're going to talk about this on day 4, processing through desire. So processing through this desire and also processing through stress and anxiety and overwhelm in a way where you're not training your mind to believe you deserve food, where you are able to process any emotion in a much more productive way that doesn't feel like this tight, I've got to distract myself, I got to go for a walk, I got to run away from it, which is so often what we hear of, like, oh, you want to eat? Just go for a walk. You want to eat? Well, eat an apple instead. What if you didn't need to do any of that? Like, how much better would that be? And so asking yourself, like, does it serve me to continue believing that I deserve it? I had a hard day. So another, and I just want to, like, give you a bunch of these models so you start to really become more familiar with it and see it, because I'm going to build on this over the next several days of, let's say there's a circumstance of 140 pounds. So that's my weight. So I want you to think about, what is your goal weight? What is that for you? And asking yourself then, what is your thought going to be about that weight? When you imagine yourself getting to your goal, what is your thought about that weight? And my thought was, I did this and I feel really proud. And the action then is no overeating, no binging. I eat when I'm hungry. I stop when I'm satisfied. And the result I create all of that is that I continue to do this. And this is so important, because this is how you, and by do this, right, I mean I stay at 140 pounds. This is also something that you're going to start practicing all along your journey, because the last thing we want to do is, like, try to kind of force our way there and then get there and be like, oh, okay, now what, right? Now I'm, like, not sure, and now I have to feel like I have to force this the rest of the way. It hasn't become part of who I am. How it becomes part of who you are and not something you're actively searching for is you're practicing becoming that person who is at your goal weight all along the way. So it's really important to ask yourself, what am I going to think when I'm there? And how can I start practicing that now? So if for me, the thought was going to be, I did this, and that's how I feel now afterwards, but how I could practice that and how I did start to practice that all along the way, in addition to, I am going to become naturally thin, like Bethany Frankel, is that I kept telling myself, no matter what the number was on the scale, and we'll get to a day where we talk about using the scale, but no matter what the number was, my thought was, I am doing this. I am doing this. I am doing this. Meaning I am doing this in a way that is lifelong. This is the last time. This is going to be permanent and sustainable and all of the things. But I really started practicing this and really started becoming that person all along the way. So for you, there's a worksheet. I want you to start doing this every day. Start getting those thoughts out on paper and start seeing how they're creating the result for you and how can we start to create a different result. And I've given you a cheat sheet for the model, for the C, the T, the F, the A, the R, the circumstance, the thought, the feeling, the action and inaction, and the results, so that you can have that, but really start to ask yourself some of these questions. And the goal is not to like get it right. The goal is to bring your awareness and to really start to see what is happening for you and why, so that we can start to change that together. So tomorrow, I'm going to talk in the second video about how to eat in a way that serves you, how to decide what you're going to eat, how to decide how you want to think about food in a completely different way. And I can't wait for you to get started. So I will see you tomorrow.